Let us discuss about thyroid inhibitors. These drugs, they reduce the functional capacity of hyperactive thyroid gland. Okay, they reduce functional capacity of hyperactive thyroid gland. The classification of these drugs include, we have mainly four classes of drugs in thyroid inhibitors. The first one is those drugs that inhibit hormone synthesis or anti-thyroid drugs. These include three drugs: prophylthioiracil, methimazole, and carbimazole. And those drugs that inhibit iodine trapping are thiocyanates, percolate, and nitrate. And those drugs that inhibit hormone release, they are iodine, iodides of sodium potassium, organic iodine. And the drugs which destroy thyroid tissue, we have only one drug here, that is radioactive iodine. Let us discuss about each of this class of drugs. The first class of drug we have here is those drugs that inhibit hormone synthesis or anti-thyroid drug. I told you this, how in this category we have mainly three drugs. They are propylthiouracil, methimazole, carbimazole. But the mechanism of action of these drugs is this drug, they inhibit thyroid peroxidase. Due to inhibition of this thyroid peroxidase, oxidation of iodine or iodotyrosine residues will not happen. Iodotyrosine residues. And due to inhibition of this oxidation, two things will get inhibited. One is iodination of tyrosine residues will not happen. Another one which gets inhibited is coupling reaction will get inhibited. Due to inhibition of coupling reaction, T3 and T4 hormones will not be produced. Okay, production of T4 and T3 hormones will get inhibited. And as these hormones are inhibited, or the production of these hormones is inhibited, hence the levels of these hormones will come down in the blood. Okay, this is about mechanism of action. There is one more mechanism that is peculiar to propylthiouracil. This propylthiouracil, it inhibits peripheral conversion of T4 to T3. Actually, T3 is the functional form of thyroid hormone. Hence, as this is inhibiting conversion of T4 to T3, the function of thyroid hormone will come down, right? For this reason, propylthiouracil is used in thyroid storm, because it inhibits peripheral conversion of T4 to T3. And all these drugs, propylthiouracil, methimazole, carbimazole, they have teratogenicity. If they are given during pregnancy, they cause hypothyroidism in fetus. And the propylthiouracil, it has got high protein binding. Due to this high protein binding, the relative presentation of propylthiouracil to the fetus will be lowered compared to other drugs because of its high protein binding. Hence, we can use in pregnancy. It has also got teratogenicity, but the teratogenicity capacity is somewhat lowered somewhat less compared to that of other two drugs because of its high protein binding. Okay, because of same reason, it is also used in lactating women. And then moving to carbimazole. This carbimazole usually acts by getting converted to methimazole. Okay, it acts after getting converted to methimazole. This carbimazole is most commonly used nowadays, and it has got high half-life. Okay, this is about carbimazole. And then we will move to pharmacokinetics of these drugs. Pharmacokinetics. They are orally absorbable. They have large volume of distribution. Will have there is large volume of distribution, and metabolism will take place in liver. Excretion will take place in urine. See, all these drugs, they accumulate in thyroid tissue. Okay, all these drugs, they accumulate in this thyroid tissue. Due to accumulation in thyroid tissue, they have got high plasma life in intrathyroid. Okay, they have got high intrathyroid half-life. Okay, this is about pharmacokinetics. Then moving to adverse effects. If you give over-treatment, then there will be hypothyroidism, and goiter will be formed. The reason why there is goiter is, when there is decreased T4 and T3 levels in the blood, there is positive feedback mechanism. There is activation of positive feedback mechanism. This feedback mechanism will result in production of TSH. Due to production of TSH, there is increase in the synthesis of colloid. There is increase in the colloid in the thyroid gland. Due to this, there is goiter. Okay, this is mechanism behind production goiter. Then other side effects. This include GIT intolerance, skin rash, joint pain, and loss of hair or graying of hair will take place, fever, and liver damage. Okay, all these things can happen. And one more rare adverse effect is agranulocytosis. Okay, and there is partial cross reactivity between carbimazole and propylthiouracil. Okay, remember this. Then we will move to use of thyroid inhibitors. They inhibit thyrotoxicosis in both Graves' disease as well as in multinodular goiter. Okay, they inhibit thyrotoxicosis. These are used as definitive therapy for Graves' disease as well as multinodular goiter. Goiter. See, in goiter, relapse is possible. Even if you do surgery, there are cases in which relapse has been seen. Hence, the definitive therapy or the best option we have is uses of these antithyroid drugs. In multinodal goiter, relapse won't happen, but if the patient does not respond to radioactive iodine, we can use these thyroid inhibitors. Okay, and this can be used as preoperatively to make the gland euthyroid. Okay, to make the person euthyroid, we use this preoperatively, and we can also use it along with radioactive iodine. Radioactive iodine. And these are important, three important uses. One is they can be used as definite to treatment for thyroid toxins for multinodular goiter as well as Graves' disease. They can be used preoperatively to make the person euthyroid, and they are used along with radioactive iodine. Okay, and the advantages of this drugs is anti-thyroid drugs is advantages, sir. See, instead of the advantage of these drugs for surgery is surgical marks will not be there, right? Surgical mark will not be there, and chances of injury to parathyroid and recurrent laryngeal will not happen. Okay, injury to parathyroid and recurrent laryngeal will not happen. And hypothyroidism, if hypothyroidism develops during our treatment, this can be reversible. Okay, and this can be these drugs can be used both in children and adults. The disadvantages are they have to be used for a very long time, right? Prolonged therapy is needed, and they cannot be used in incooperative patients. Okay, and there is some drug toxicity. These are the disadvantages. Okay, and I already told you that in propylthiouracil can be used in pregnancy as well as in lactating women, and moreover this propylthiouracil can be used in thyroid stoma as well. Okay, thank you for watching. In the next video we'll discuss about iodine and iodates as well as radioactive iodine. Thank you for watching.